Breaking news, the news that you guys all have been waiting for. I finally have an update for you. Now, your boy Kung JIN and TAKEDA will be returning in Mortal Kombat 12. I got the memo just morning and I couldn't wait to make this video and put it out so you guys can be notified as soon as possible. Now, I know this video is not as long as the others because I just got this information. I'm waiting for more details, so it will be an update on this video. So I want to pass this question off to you guys in the comment section below. How do you feel about Kung JIN and TAKEDA returning? Now, I'll be completely honest with you. I missed the MKX train, so I did not get to play with either of these characters, but I did see how they play, and I love the fact that one of those characters, I'm not sure which one it was, you can correct me if I get it wrong, but one of those characters had a bow and arrow, and that reminded me of the Green Arrow. And there's no characters in Mortal Kombat 11 that I could think of other than Nightwolf that has a staff, or I should say a bow and arrow. Now, even though Nightwolf uses a bow and arrow, that's not his primary thing, because he'll beat the brakes off you. He got his little tomahawk or whatever it's called. He does his Thug Dizzle, but the arrow is not really like a main part of him. I'm not going to say it ain't a main part of him because it's part of his green energy, but it's not his signature weapon directly out the gate. So to have a character with a signature weapon of a bow, a crossbow, that's going to be super dope because I would be so interested in using that. That's going to be really, really good. So I'm looking forward to that. And like I said, TAKEDA, I believe he's the one that had the little snake thing, the little scorpion circle spin thingy that was almost like a chain. Again, you can correct me if I'm saying it's the wrong person, but he seemed like he had some pretty dope moves too. So I can't wait to see what they're going to do with these guys. I'm kind of relieved that they're coming back because it's like, why did you have the other combat kids, but you didn't bring these two back at all? And then I can't wait to see how they're going to interact with the other characters in story mode. Yes, I'm told that they're going to be a part of that DLC pack that's going to be coming. It's going to be the character pack as far as the aftermath update as to what's going to happen. That's when they're going to be coming back at that point in time. So I'm excited. I don't even know how to feel at this point. Again, I know this video is not as long as the other ones, but it just feels good because they're going to give these characters another chance or whatever. Now, they were left out because they wanted to include two new characters. That's the main reason why they were left out of MK11. So the characters that replaced them was Collector and Cetrion. Those are the two characters that replaced them and the reason why they were not able to get on the roster. Because remember, we got three new characters for MK11. We got Gearis, we got Collector, and we got Cetrion. If I'm missing somebody, feel free to let me know, but I don't think I did. Those are the three new characters that we got for that game. Why do I feel like I'm missing somebody? Is there a new character in MK11 that I'm missing? Let me see. Collector, we got Gearis, and then we also got Cetrion. We had three characters. Sorry about that, my alarm going off, which means it's almost about time for me to get up out of here. So we had three new characters. Now, we did have Kronika, but Kronika was not a playable character at all, so I'm not counting her. That's why she was not mentioned at all. Now, if this video is not a live video, you know, we usually do the gatherings and we will get live and watch the videos and things of that nature. If it's not a live video, then that's because the video wasn't long enough to be alive. I don't want to have you guys sit around for 5 minutes just to watch a 3-minute video. That makes no sense at all. You know, if the video is at least 10 minutes, we get 20 minutes to kind of spend with each other chatting. So if this is a live, for those of you guys over there in the right hand corner that's in the comment box, shout out to all the moderators, shout out to everybody down there. I appreciate you showing up, supporting and moderating and doing your job and everything. For those of you that are watching the video live, yes, all of you, get your behind over there in the comment box and start commenting and interacting with people and stop being a ninja washer watching from all the way behind bushes and stuff. Like the video and become a supporter. But anyway, let's get back on topic here. Kung JIN and TAKEDA, their moveset is going to be crazy from what I'm told. I can't wait for the dialogue and everything. Now, there will be references to them missing MK11. So that's going to be dope for them to talk about how that's going to happen. Now, I'm expecting them to say something like, Kronika locked me in the void. You know, I would have helped this, that, or the third. Or I was off Earth or whatever the case is. So it's gonna be interesting to see what type of BS and shenanigans that they gonna come up with. I'm interested in seeing what they gonna do with that going forward, because you know they always gotta come up with some funny content and everything and stuff. So that's gonna be pretty good. I'm excited for that. So I wanna pass this question off to you guys in the comments section below. Which between the two, Kung Jin and Takeda, are you excited about? That you want to see the most? That you ready to play with? Did you main any of these characters in Mortal Kombat X? Again, I didn't get a chance to do so. When I did play Mortal Kombat X, quick story, I went to Jackie. I played with Jackie, but I'm not going to lie. MKX was the first time in a while that I played a Mortal Kombat game. I'm not going to lie, I felt kind of out of pocket, meaning that it didn't feel like the same Mortal Kombat because there were so many new characters, like all those combat kids. It felt lazy. It felt different. That was just like my outside perspective, but it kind of grew on me later. So I really didn't know who to play with, but I did gravitate towards Jackie and playing with her. And that's basically Jackie and Jax, Reptile and Aramac are the only characters that I really, you know, got my hands on to play with. Now, and I think we all can agree that MKX was a nice introduction for Mortal Kombat to come back, because MK9 was pretty good too, but MKX was just on a whole nother level. And then MK11 kind of, you know, landed the plane as far as making the game realistic and being able to kind of have the good graphics, the good storytelling and things that we were able to get. And now we're looking to see where MK12 is going to take this game now that the other games has, you know, carried it. So let's hope MK12 going dog walk MK11 and MKX and MK9 for that matter. So we can, like I said, have us a good game and everything. I'm excited to see what their costumes is going to look like, especially with the new systems and stuff that's coming. They did have some very, very unique stuff from what I saw. And MKX, from what I can, you know, remember right off memory, they had some unique costumes. So what they're getting ready to do with these going forward, I think it'll be something mind-bending and mind-blowing, because I mean, my favorite part of a Mortal Kombat game is looking at the outfits and how they come up with something different and just get super super creative. For example, giving Jackie an entire tech suit was pretty dope. Like, she on some Iron Man stuff and everything, but I do think her MKX outfit that she had was pretty dope too, and they could have bought over some of those elements. Now, you could make the argument that it's the same suit or whatever, you know, same technology, but we both know Jackie got some she got some really good stuff compared to you know, more than the other characters. You know, her having the barriers, the bombs, the rockets, the explosions. One thing that she did not have though was shooting bullets out of her wrist. But they did include it. I think that's a part of her X-ray, not with her X-ray or Fatal Blow in MK11. So, I mean, I got to get them credit for that. They did keep it in there, but it's only used for that matter. And I think Sonya actually uses the same wrist blasters where she knocked the opponent into the air and she shoot them and they get chopped up out of helicopter. So that's probably one of the reasons why. But at the same time, Sonya didn't even shoot that shit out of her wrist doing in-game gameplay. She shot the Sonya rings, so they could have at least gave that to Jackie as far as being able to shoot bullets at that speed. Now, is there another character that does that? Let me think. I think Spawn did it. Yeah, Spawn had like a machine, some machine gun action. Who else had a gun? Aaron Black had a gun. He had some gun action. Oh, never mind. Cassie got it with the pistols. So that's probably why she didn't get it, because they didn't want them to play exactly the same. Cassie got it with the pistols where she shoot her own bullets. And if you charge it hard enough, she get the green bullets type stuff. So never mind. Scratch that. I understand why they didn't give her what she needed, because somebody else already had it. But anyway, let me go ahead and get you guys on up out of here. Pass this question off to you guys in the comment section below. Again, which one of these characters you're looking forward to seeing the most? For me, I'm going to have to go, this is a hard choice. Kung Jin is pretty good. He's pretty good. He's unique. But Takeda is lit, though. This is a tough pick for me, but I got to pick one. Y'all got to pick one, too. Get in the comments. I'm going to have to go with Kung Jin. I'm going to go with Kung Jin because he got this little voodoo vibe about him with that little stick he be carrying. I believe he got like some little stick or something that you beat the brakes off you with. So I'm just going to have to go with him. But anyway, I appreciate you guys watching. Stay tuned for the next video. Catch you in the next one. Like, comment, subscribe, share with a friend.